Let me explain the task for the next lab. It is going, you got to write an ELP for reversal of a string, right? So there are two problem statements. In the first one, you got to write an program to reverse a given string and store it in the same location, like starting from an memory, some memory, a string is given, that is a set of data is given. So you need to reverse it. Reverse it means the last data has to come to the first place and the first data needs to go to the last, and so on and so forth. So everything read. And in the second one, in the second program, you got to use an indirect addressing method, and then from the source it has to paste the data into some other location. Okay, now it's not the same location, it's going to be in the some other location, but then again here also it has to paste it in the reverse order. So both are in the reverse order. In the first problem, it's in the same location. Now here the target and the source locations are different here. So that is the difference. So let me explain you a little bit about the program and then you can complete it. Okay. Here in the first problem, there is some restriction, that is no other memory is to be used. So whatever is the same memory, you need to take data from there. You can't even use a temporary memory. You have to use, say, in the same memory locations, you need to write a program where the data gets reversed. The sequence of the data gets reversed. Okay, you have to use the exchange command. And so this is an example. Suppose from a location 300 from 3000, the data stored is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 up to 9, right? So after execution of the command, right, so this is the data from 1 to 9 starting from 3000. After execution of the command, right, it has to at 3000 it will be 9, and 3008 it will be 0. So this order is changed. Now it is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So this is the final output should be like, right? So let me just show you a pseudo code for that, right? So the first, we need to so SI, so for example, if the SI is 4000, right, and then you have fed these in a string of data, which is 1 2 3 4 5 6, 7 data is fixed here. So you are going to move the first into SI this location where this data starts, and CL, what is the thing which we need to write? Anybody can make a guess? Anybody? It is just CL is the half of the length string. No, we'll write the full length, okay, of the string. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5, since it is 7, so we are going to write 7 out here, right? So there are two counters, okay. Now CL and CH, we are going to decrease CL and increase CH, and we'll just see when they are coming to be equal, right? So and in DI, so now in DI we are going to load the address of the last element. Okay, so if this is 4000, what would be this? Anybody? It would be 4006, right? So this will be 4006 and this will be 4000. So that you have, then you take this move data AL and into the first that this one we are going to get into AL, and this 7 we are going to get into BL, right? And then we are writing an exchange and a BL with some memory location, right? So BL, so BL is 7, we need to exchange it with what? We got to exchange it with this memory location. So we are going to write this value of here, right? It is going to be 4000, and here this has to be SI and this has to be DI, then the data will get an exchange, right? So once you change this data, so this exchange would happen, and then in the next step we are going to increase the SI and DI, right? Decrease DI. So we are going to from the right hand side we are going to come towards the left and decreasing the data, and from the left hand side we are going towards the right, so we are going to increase SI, right? So we are going to do between 2 and 6 in the next run. So you increase SI and you decrease data, and here we need to also do, since we have already taken the count as here the total number, so we need to decrease this count also. So we have to increase CH and decrease an CL. So we increase an CH and decrease CL, and then compare CL and CH. Okay, so as long as CL is greater than CH, okay, we are, or if the this is greater, if CL is greater than CH, it is going to make a jump again, so it will take again the next data, so this cycle would complete. So let me put this. Okay, so in the first run we are going to load CL as 7 and CH as 0. Okay, so what is going to happen is, it is going to now in the first run, the 1 and 7 is going to get swapped, right? And then you are going to increase SI and DI, right? And then you are also going to increase CH and decrease CL. So now CL CH will become 6 and 1. Then you are again comparing it. Again, when you are comparing, is jump if greater. So this is greater. It is going to jump and execute this loop once more. So now 2 and 6 will get swapped, right? And then again CL and CH will get amended to 5 and 2. So since again 5 is greater than 2, it will go to the loop again, and 3 and 5 will get swapped with each other, right? And in the next run, it becomes 4 and 3. So it is going to run once again, right? 4 and 3, and then it is going to come as, and this is going to come as an 4 4, and then your CL and CH, it is 3 4, and in the next after this it will going to go. Now if you see here what is happening, it is 4 3, right? 3 and 5 has got swapped here. Okay, then you get after that it is 4 3, and in 4 3 also, since it is greater, it will run it once again, and it will swap the data between 4 and 4. So it doesn't make any sense. It's not going to change the data, but nevertheless this loop will run. Okay, because we have written JG here, so greater, then it is going to make one more, and this is an redundant one loop will be redundant out here, right? And then in the next loop, it is going to come as 3 and 4. Here it is less than 4, so it will come out of the loop. So is this clear to all of you? Or if it is not clear, I can explain it once again. Yeah, so it says you can't take, because it is even number, right? It is an odd number of strings. So 2 will be, if you take by half, it will become 3.5. So if you take, whether it has to be taken 3 or it has to be taken 4, okay, so there will be a confusion there, because and not necessarily it will be even always, it could be odd also. So that is the reason why it is it is taken the full strength, and they are taken 2 counters, and one we are decreasing and one we are increasing, and then we are comparing. Is it okay, Suchit? Why is that we are not taking a half value of the string in the counter? Okay, so let me give you one more example, in which if we have, suppose we have a total 8 bits out here instead of 1 to 7 and 8 also, if we have 8 also, what happens is we are going to load 8 out here, and then 0 0 here in CH. So in the first run, 1 and 8 will get interchanged, right? Then this will get increased, so now the counter CL will become 7 and this will become 1 out here, right? And then it will become 2 and 7 will get swapped with each other. Okay, then it will become 6, and then it will become 2 CL, and CL will decrease and CH will increase. 6 and 2, the loop will be executed once more, and then you have 3 and 6 data, well, and 3 and 6 they are going to get exchanged with each other, and then you have one more decrement of CL and increment of CH out here, 5C, it is still greater, so 4 and 5 will get exchanged, and then you have this both coming to equal, right? Now since it is greater, now it will exit, and here it is not making an redundant loop, here it is making a redundant loop. Okay, So in the odd case, it is making one redundant loop. In the even case, it's not making. It is just coming out of the required four swaps. It's 8. It will make an 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It will just make the 4 runs. Here also, it will, because it is 7, still it's making 4 runs. So here it is not making. It is both the cases, it is making an 4 runs. Okay. So in many textbooks, and in fact in the original lab manual which was given to me, it was written as JGE, okay, jump if greater than or equal, it is written. So that is actually an erroneous thing to do, okay. Why I will tell you, okay, because in the actual problem which was given to you, there was only 7 bytes, okay. So that would work if you write JGE here, that would work here, because if you see, it is greater than or equal to. So so that equal to condition is not coming here. So it will go here, it is greater, it will make a loop. Here it is less than, so it will not do any, it will exit. But when we are taking an even number of strings out here, so it will come equal out here, right? And when it is coming equal, you want it to exit, okay. If you write JGE here, jump if greater than or equal to, what would happen? It will do one more loop, and in that loop, this 5 and 4 will get again interchanged, okay, one more time. So in the final result, you will find, and it is erroneous actually. 4 and 5 will change twice, they will get exchanged twice, and it will get reverted back to the original value. So refer the original manual. So whatever I am uploading, just please refer to that. So there is no E here, okay. In some of the textbooks and in the internet also, some of the people who have posted this program, you will find it is JJE, but that E will cause a problem for if there are even number of strings. Is it understood by everybody? Okay, what is the problem if writing with GJE, JGE, right? It is going to, if it is equal also, this is going to run it for one more time, and changing that, and it would change the data between 4 and 5 once again, second time. So okay, so can somebody suggest, can we modify this a little bit further, so that you will find in the even it is doing an redundant sweep, right, loop. So how can we eliminate that? Anybody? Can I think of something? So let me give you one solution for that, right? Okay. So if you take if you are going to load into CL one value lesser than the total number of strings, okay. So instead of 7 in this case, I am taking 6. Okay, for this case, if I take 6, so what is going to happen in the first run? 1 and 7 is going to get swapped, and this is going to change to 5 and 1. And in the second run, 2 and 6 are going to be interchanged. Then this is going to change to 4 and 2. And in the and then 3 and 5 are going to get changed. Okay, then this is going to come to 3 and 3, and it will exit the loop out here. So there is no redundant, because you have written JG. So it is going to jump if greater only. So it is not a greater condition, it is equal condition. So it will come out of the loop here, right? Now if I check what is going to happen for the odd number of string, here also instead of 8, if I write 7 out here, okay. So in the first sweep, 1 and 8 will get changed, right? It will get interchanged. Then it becomes 6, 1. And then it is going to change to 6, 1. And then 2 and 7 are going to get swapped. Then it is going to change to 5, 2. 3 and 6 are going to get swapped. Then it is going to become 4, 3. And 4 and 5 are going to get swapped. Then it will become 3, 4. And it will come out of the loop, right? So we can avoid that one redundant sweep by putting the value of CL as total number of string minus 1. If you do that, then we can avoid that redundant sweep. So when you are making these kind of programs, so you have to be careful with these kind of things. Okay. So let me explain you the second problem. Okay. Here it is where you are going to use the load SB and store SB commands out here, right? And also the direction. So if we have this data the data is starting from 3000, suppose, right? And then this data needs to be reversed. Okay, so if you have to reverse the data, the starting address is not 2000. The whatever available in 3000 will get stored to 2000, whereas the data will be reversed. It will go into the negative direction. Like the first data will come to 2000, the second data will go to 2000 minus 1. Okay, so how to do that? So you have you are taking this SI 3000 here, DI 2000. And then you are going to put a counter out here. So there are five bits. So you could do initialize it into five, right? And this is clear the direction, and load SB, right? So load SB is going to get the first data into the into the A accumulator, right? Load SB gets data into the accumulator, and then it from the memory location from DI, right? And then you are writing, you are going to set the direction again back. So when you set the direction back, what happens is after load SB, okay, what it does, since it is clear direction, the SI is going to be incremented here automatically. Okay, so once this command is executed, that is the data from 3000 is loaded into the accumulator. Okay, SI will increment by one, right? And then now you are changing the direction of the direction flag. Okay, you are going to set it to one, and then you are writing store. So the data is going to be pushed to 2000, and then the DI will be decremented in this case, because it is the direction flag is set to one. So obviously DI will be decremented because it's going to be in the reverse direction. So DI will get decremented out here, right? And then you are writing a loop, okay, because it is going to repeat it five times. So each time SI will be incremented and DI will be decremented. So at the end of this program, what would happen is all the data, this 00 will come to 2000, and 1 will come to one memory location which is less than 2000, okay, before the 2001, that is 2000 minus 1, right? 2 will go to 2000 minus 2, 3 will go to 2000 minus 3, and 4 will go to 2000 minus 4, right? So in case you want to modify this program so that this 4 comes at 2000, and then 03 comes at 2001, if you want, like whatever was the data starting from 3000 to from 3000 you had, right? 01234. Now from 2000 I want 43210. So what is the change which we need to do in this program? Tell me, anybody? See, I want the data to be starting from, right? From 3000, right? I want the same data to be available in the reverse order, starting from 2000. Like 2000, I want data 4. 2001, right? I want 3. 2002, I want 2, and henceforth. So, what is the change in this program? SI will be again 3000, right? What will be DI? Anybody? Okay, DI has to be 1234, like there are five, right? So DI has to be 2004 in that case, right? Yeah, if you write 2004 here DI, right? So what it is going to, in the first clear, it is clear direction, so load SB. So from 3000, the first data will be fetched into the accumulator, and then SI will be increased. So it will go to SI will go to 3001. Then you have changed the direction of the flag. So, and then you have written in the DI 2004. So that data will be stored into 2004 here, right? And then that it is, since the direction flag has been set to one, so in the and DI will automatically get decremented to 2003. So the next data will get into 2003, and like that, in the last data will come to 2000. So that is how we can do that. Okay, so these are the two things which you need to do it for your next lab, right? And these are some review questions. You can go through that. Okay. This is just one program which is given. The entire program is given here. Home assignment, right? This one. The entire thing is given here. You have to go through it and you have to try and understand how it works. Okay. So this is an you are writing a string out here and you have to reverse it. Okay, print it. So it is using a procedure. So nothing is hidden out here. The entire program is given here. So what you need to just refer to the theory which has been taught in the class, and then and you don't have to show this in the next lab also. You just have to go through it and try to understand this, and in case there is any doubt, you can get it clarified in the next lab. Okay, so that's all for today. Now if there are any doubts, you can ask me, else we'll start with the Viva for the last experiment. Okay, thanks a lot.